So we'll move on to the variation GTAW, because we looked at all the main components I showed you: power source, shielding gas, arc, isn't it? So these are the three important components in a welding circuit. Now we'll see how we can carefully modify these to improve the welding characteristics, to change the microstructure, to increase the productivity. Okay. Or you increase, improve the bead geometry, appearance, aesthetics. So by carefully manipulating the physics of arc, the waveforms, okay, and also the power sources, we can improve the process stability and the weld characteristics significantly. Okay, so we'll see some variations, some improvements that happened in a GTAW in a subsequent slides. For example, instead of using a constant current, you can also have a pulsed current. It has its own benefit. Okay, in terms of arc characteristics, you can significantly improve the arc stiffness by using a pulsed DC, and we can also increase the frequency of pulsing, and high frequency pulsing. Okay, and that will also improve the arc characteristics. Again, I already told about the square wave alternating current, because sinusoidal waves are very energy inefficient. Okay, so instead of having a sinusoidal current, you may also have a square wave alternating current, and you can also induce variable polarity in DC for some the applications. You can use DC current to weld aluminium, but because we have a complex power sources, we can also switch the polarity in a given cycle, so that you get advantage of DC, and then you also have an advantage of changing the polarities. Okay, and then subsequently, the modification is carried out in the welding setup. For example, the plasma welding. Okay, so it is not arc welding, isn't it? So in these cases, gas tungsten arc welding. But as I already explained, not all the arcs are plasmas, right? So there must be critical condition to achieve plasma state. What is that? So yeah, so you need to have electrical neutrality. How do you achieve that? Increasing electrons. How do you do that? See, everything is fixed. Shielding gas is fixed, power source is fixed. Okay, your setup is fixed. Can you convert arc into plasma? What pressure? Increase gas pressure. In what way? You mean gas flow rate? Will it change arc into plasma? No. So we need to do one small trick to the arc, then arc becomes plasma. Okay, we'll see in that in plasma welding case. Okay. So and then we can also add wires as a consumable. So you have an arc, and then you feed the wire, so that you melt the wire, and you fill the cavity effectively. So it can be cold wire, hot wire. And then you may also have a dual gas. So basically you use two shielding gases to achieve platform, and then you can also, yeah, plasma. You have a multi-cathode GTAW, an activated TIG using fluxes. You change the fluid flow behavior to improve the penetration, and then you can also have buried arc TIG, and then high current gas tungsten arc welding as well. We will see the first two in this class, and then we will wind up quickly. Right, we'll see one by one. So all the characteristics, and then we move on to the next chapter. Good, pulse GTAW. So why do you need that? What is pulse GTAW? So in this case, you don't see a constant current. Instead of that, you pulse the current as a function of time. So it is beneficial, instead of having constant current in GTAW, having a pulse current, because it improves the arc stiffness tremendously. because you also increase by doing pulsing, you also constantly change your E. So that means that the acceleration, the mean free path of electrons and ions, it also changes. So when you continuously change the input, the I mean. So due to that, the arc stiffness, the arc core temperature also changes significantly. Okay. So you increase the number of electrons which are colliding, and also you increase the number of electrons that are generated because of this collision, and due to that the arc characteristic, arc temperature, arc stiffness, arc core changes to good. So by instead of using a constant current, using a pulse current, so you can change the arc stiffness effectively, because so if you calculate the I mean, okay, for this waveform, so somewhere for example 60, right, and if you apply a constant current of 60 amperes, the arc stiffness would be much lower than having a pulse. But in this pulse case, you are going at an IP pulse current much higher than your mean current. So in this case, and because of the high current, obviously you also change locally the ionization in the arc, is not it? The number of N you change at a given time. So because you have a relationship, right, the electron current in the arc. So you change the N as well, because E is changed instantly. The at that moment you change, so the N as well as the mean free length, the L, and due to that, and you effectively you are welding at its shorter the pulse time with very high current. So you generate the electrons and you bring it down and you keep a background and then cycle it again. So that means that by in a way you are welding, you are generating the arc effectively with very high current, but you are not maintaining it. If you are maintaining that, then your heat generation will also be enormous, huge. So by carefully pulsing from high current to low current, background current, you modify the arc characteristics, arc stiffness at the arc envelope significantly. So this is very beneficial. So if you use in a 60 amp mean current, the direct the constant current, and the arc stiffness will be very effective, very good if you use an a pulsing current. Okay, and this is possible to generate such a waveform because of the power source what we have by using a switching transformers, switching transistors, I am sorry, switching transistors. We can generate such a waveforms, is not it? So by rapidly switching on and off, right, so you can generate a pulsing. But in this process, if you calculate the I mean, the average, it will be much lower, but the arc characteristics are much improved greatly because of this pulsing. Yes, so generally for a given material, so IP plus TP is a constant, and that is characteristic of the material, generally we choose. So what are the advantage of the pulsed GTAW? Because of using the pulsed current, so we can reduce the distortion and you can improve tolerance, because the arc characteristics, arc stiffness improves significantly, and you can use the dissimilar thicknesses because of that, and dissimilar materials, and thermal buildup can be reduced because the I mean is lower, is not it? So the heat input can be decreased. And this we will talk about in bit later, the cost to cost variation, and that can influence the weld geometry significantly, because locally there could be some change in compositions, and those kind of variation can be overcome by using pulsed GTAW. And generally these kind of waveforms widely used for in a very demanding applications like cryogenic bellows, nuclear plant pipelines and air engine components. Okay. It's good. So we'll wind up.